And we basically had come to an agreement with Splice at the time because they weren't going to get the LEC spot. This was the year of the franchising, and their application got turned down. So their players were free to speak to other teams. They could join other teams. And what ended up happening is that at the end, two organizations pulled out. I think it was North and the Spanish team. Maybe Movistar Riders pulled out because they didn't like the deal, or I think Movistar Riders had to change their name. So they pulled out. Guess what happens? Splice gets the ninth spot, XL gets the 10th spot, and now Splice says, sorry, but we're not selling any of our players to a rival team in Europe. So Niski got shipped off to America. And again, we had to then look for players in the ERLs. And then it was Nemesis, Leader, and Magi Felix that were on our list. And what I wanted to do was I wanted to have a six-man roster with Leader and Nemesis with Magi Felix behind them. Of course,
Ooh, that's an interesting premise.
it's wishful thinking as well, of course, because not everyone is happy to share a position.
I'm pretty sure that most of them, like at least the first two of the three, definitely would want to be a starter, right?
Yeah, I mean, I asked Nemesis Leader how they felt about it, and they're like, no, I don't want to share a spot. They were just straight about it, and quite frankly, I can respect that as well. So we had to make a decision between the two, and we chose Nemesis.
Right, what was the thinking behind why you picked him up? Like, did you have a sense of, like, from watching him in the Mad Lions team, I'm talking about the ERL team here, obviously, did you have a sense of, like, because obviously, let's be real, like, no one's just going to come in and be Caps. Like, they're not going to do what Caps did. They're going to be that style of player. So presumably you were trying to identify something specifically about this is what Nemesis is going to do for this team. Like, what did you envision him as a mid laner doing?
At the time, I was mostly being led by the players, and for the players, it was a really quick decision because we at some point had to involve the likes of Weepo, Hilly, and Broxah, and we just said, like, listen, hey, these are the guys on our list. And the first thing, I think one of the two of them said, Leader, nope, that guy is too toxic in solo queue. That's not happening. So if it's between those two, let's go with Nemesis. Now, we did push a little bit, and we ended up sending Broxah to duo queue with Nemesis, I believe, and he came back very positively. We watched his games from the ERL. And he just did what I kind of wanted: play control mages, play them well, play good in team fights, be consistent, reliable. So nothing that Caps was, because Caps was as unreliable as possible, but also in the best way most of the games. But I felt, you know what? If I can get a reliable mid laner, I have a star-studded team around him. It's going to work. And it didn't at the start. It kind of did at the end. But it was a rough year.